Today we're going to learn how to make a vector vintage tattoo style of design in Adobe Illustrator. But if you want to skip the intro, move to the timestamp in the corner. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. Today I'm going to show you techniques and tricks for designing a kind of vector style vintage tattoo design in Illustrator. However, first, if you have Instagram and you want to follow me on there, my handle is Satori_graphics. I post kind of goofy random stuff from time to time, things you won't see on YouTube and Twitter, and lots of graphic designs. So go ahead and give me a follow if you do use Instagram. In a new document in Illustrator, hit Command R on a Mac or Control R on a PC to open up your rulers. We need one guide vertically and one guide horizontally. We will use the horizontal guide to make sure the pen tool path does not go above it, as we need to duplicate the path and join it later, and we want it to remain flat across the top. Make a path like mine here with the pen tool, which is going to be half of a shield. Once you've made it, right-click the canvas and then hide guides. Hold down the Alt Option key to duplicate the path, like so, and then reflect the line. We then need to perfectly align them and hit Command or Control J to join them together. We now have the shield shape for a vector vintage tattoo style design. Right click the background to show the guides and then unlock them, and make guides similar to mine here. We will use the same process as we did before with the shield to make half of a ribbon that is going to go around our vector design. You can also go back with the direct selection tool and edit the path at any point, but make sure the path finishes along the same vertical guide because we need to join together later. Hide your guides and then resize and duplicate the path, and then reflect it and join it as we did before with Command or Control J. Now, open up the appearance panel so we can add multiple strokes to our ribbon design. Add a white fill and then add a black stroke, but remember to drag the stroke below the fill layer. We're going to add some more strokes later in the tutorial. Show your guides in Illustrator and then unlock them if they're locked. We want a guide running down the center of our ribbon. Using the pen tool, make a line like mine and edit it with the direct selection tool. This is going to be part of the detail on our vector design today, so increase the stroke weight and then add the same stroke style as mine here. A great tip for designing things in this nature is to design half of them and then duplicate them to save time. This works with symmetrical designs. So go ahead and duplicate the detail line and reflect it over on the other side. Using the align window, we're going to make sure they're both level. With the ribbon selected, you can open the appearance panel and add some more strokes if that's what you want to do in your design. Remember though to drag the strokes below the fill layer and then change the weight and the color. You can duplicate the detail line and move it above. You can then edit it with the direct selection tool and change the stroke weight. Once you've done this multiple times, you can take the width tool to really have full control over the stroke weight along the entire line. This is going to act like shading on the vector tattoo design. Once happy with your shading, select the ribbon and then the two lower lines and then lock them. And yep, you've guessed it, we're going to be duplicating the shading lines and then reflecting them on the other side. Take your time to reposition them in place properly. So now unlock everything on your canvas in Illustrator and then select the entire ribbon section of the design. Then hold down Shift and click the ribbon itself to essentially deselect it. We can then go ahead and outline the stroke of the detailed lines. This will make sure that when we resize the design, the strokes will going to remain proportional. You can also change your stroke settings to scale proportionally. Duplicate the shield shape and then resize it behind the ribbon. With the pen tool, click one side of the shield and then hold down Shift to make a straight line until you reach the other side. Curve the line with the bezier curves and then continue the path like so. With the new shape selected, hold down Shift to select the shield as well and then open up the Pathfinder window. Use this option here to leave the lower part of the shield remaining. Using the pen tool, I've added this section here to represent more shadow. And as before, duplicate it and then reflect it over to the other side. Make sure that you position it perfectly in place, and then use a direct selection tool to edit the paths if need be. As you can see here, I'm using direct selection tool to adjust my paths on my vector design. To simulate shading in this area of the design, use the pen tool and make lines we've done previously, adding the same stroke style as before. Using the pen tool, add in any details to your vintage tattoo style design, and then as before, select them all and then duplicate them over the other side. The width tool is always there if you need it also. So here's my design so far. You can go ahead and open up and unlock the guides, as we might need them for a central guide down the middle. Duplicate the shield on the right hand side and use the Pathfinder tool process to cut a piece of it out as we did before. Flip the shape from a fill to a stroke and increase the stroke weight. Then using the scissors tool, cut out two sections in the top part. Then use a direct selection tool to select and delete the top anchor points. At this stage, you can outline the stroke of this line here, and then adjust the corners of the line so it looks professional at the top edge. Here, I've added some simple curved lines with the pen tool, and then I hold down shift to select every line at the same time, and increase the stroke weight and add the same stroke style as I'm using here. As before, you can use the direct selection tool to adjust the lines, and do this for the other side as well to simulate highlights on the shield or the vector design. The shield on the far right needs to be behind all other layers, and then move it into place. I've cut the shield into two parts so we can arrange them independently in case there isn't enough room on the top of the design. Duplicate the shield once you have it in place, and then flick the fill over to a white stroke. You can hold down shift and the alt option key at the very same time to resize it in place. As we did at the bottom of our shield, add more lines at the top to simulate light bouncing off the vintage vector tattoo design. The text I've added in here in the middle uses the font Tower. And for a final touch on the design, we can make an X shape using the pen tool like so. Copy and reflect the line and then align them. The font I'm using for this part is Trajan Pro. Make sure to outline the stroke and outline the type before you edit the color and the place of your design. We'll be right back. And there you have it, one vintage vector tattoo style design in Illustrator. This was quite a lengthy tutorial, so I hope you guys followed along and you found it useful. Remember to like and share my content if you do enjoy it. And subscribe for 3 weekly graphic design uploads here at Satori Graphics. So until next time, design your future today. Peace.